Well, if you are like most, you are still trying to find the purpose in your life, and indeed, you could use some help in doing it. According to our next guest, you may need only look as far as your job, your vocation, basically, for a lot of the answer. That's right, your job says a whole lot more about you and your life than you might think. Her new book, The Purpose of Life, it's Carol Adrian. She tells us your job really says a lot about the purpose of your life. It's nice to have you with us.
Thank you. Nice to be here.
We should say that also co-author of the Celestine Prophecy and
The Experiential Guide.
The Experiential Guide. Thank you very much. The purpose of your life. Now, this is something that clearly we all are looking for. Many people feel that they have found. Others are still wandering around 50, 60 years out.
That's true.
You know?
You can get there at any time. I think you do ask these questions at different stages of your life, too. You know, and I think a lot of people are asking it in more in the 40s and 50s as they complete some successes and then they go into asking what's next. And I really think this is the question for the decade, the 90s. People are wanting to know what is out there. There's got to be something more.
Well, a lot of people would say, you know, looking to your vocation as the purpose of your life seems to be going against all the spirituality, all the family orientation that we have come to in the 1990s.
Well, I'm not advocating that that's the only place to look at it.
Yeah.
But you can look at your life purpose in such a broad scope. And I want to make the point here, too, that life purpose is not just finding the right job title. But if the work that you're doing has, you know, you've gotten there for some reason, so you could look at with the past of how you got there and then look at what you like about it now. So what does it tell you about your natural characteristics and how you go about doing things? Really, your life purpose is how you're being in the world.
Now, we've got some of the ways that that you kind of ascertain how to make decisions and how to do things in order to give yourself that focus that you might be looking for. And you first of all say, act on passion.
Right. One of the most powerful things you can do in life in general is to have a clear idea. I liked what Michael Lyden was saying about Ray Charles. He knew what he wanted to do. So he had the calculation, the mental acuity, and then he put in what? The passion, the emotion. And that is what will get us moving. Even in business, if you've got a strong feeling about something, that's showing you there's energy there. There's a direction to follow.
But you have to be discerning, don't you? I mean, you really do have to make smart decisions along the way.
Right, and discerning is an interesting word because we have to learn how to make choices and what are our values. Is this really, you know, something that I think is a good idea, or is it just, you know, expedient in the moment? So our values tell us a lot about what our purpose in life is, too. You know, you can be in a certain job, but if you're selling out, in a sense, you're not really doing what you came here to do. If you have a message, if you have something else, another point of view, you have to really be discriminating there and not just let the marketplace, you know, define who you are.
A lot of people are so taken in with what's going on around them that they don't listen to what is within.
So being discerning is really important. You have to make choices. And how do you make those choices? On what you feel is right, what your values are.
Energy is something a lot of people lose out on there if they're so involved in other things and just are so depressed by things. They lose all that energy.
Exactly. We do that a lot. So one of the best ways of, you know, in your work of any kind is to really watch your energy, because some people are going to drain your energy.
Yeah.
And those are ones, that's a sign, that's feedback telling you, wait a minute, I need to rethink this and not listen to this person or really, you know, really question what they're saying. If you're losing energy, your body never lies. So if you're losing energy around something, you really need to look again, and that's where the discernment comes in. You know, okay, stop and take a moment to reassess.
And the commitment comes in. I mean, the passion. You really have to want to do things, don't you?
Yeah, we only have a certain amount of time every day.
And it goes so fast.
Right, and so do the things that matter. Do what's really important to you, and stop doing some of the things that are where you're just putting in time.
You talk about synchronicity.
One of my favorite words.
A lot
words.
In your book. It's a great word.
Yes.
Every
It was coined by Carl Jung, of course. It's like when two coincidences come together, and it doesn't look like there's a reason why. It's very mysterious.
Yeah.
But you suggest there is.
But there is something going on. And a lot of times synchronicity is interesting. It seems to answer an unspoken question. And it may be coming just at the right time when you go, oh, I've heard so many great stories in my book where people fell into meeting somebody at the cafeteria and they turned out to be their next lead. So a lot of times these coincidences are really part of something that is working in your favor. I believe there are no accidents.
Yeah. It is that process, and you should trust.
Trust your process. Right.
That, Some,
you have an inborn purpose, and it will take you where you need to go.
It is the purpose of your life. Carol Adrian's latest book. If you're looking, you might well find it with the help of this book. Thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We're going to take some time for some news. Be back.